Now, she was actually able to find a solution, I'm happy to say. And because this is the Feldenkrais Summit, it may not surprise you to hear that it had something to do with the Feldenkrais method. And I'm going to tell you about that, but in order for it to make sense, we need to first look at why what she was doing, why the physical therapy and resting did not work for her. And so here's the situation. So as I said, this kind of story may sound familiar to you, maybe painfully familiar. Either to have the same injury recur after therapy and or rest, or to have something else come up, you know, to have a portion of every year you can run, you can train, and every year something happens. You do seem to get better when you get physical therapy or you rest, but then it's the running, when you go back to running or when you go up to a certain threshold, like for a lot of people it's hitting that distance of 6 or 7 miles, all of a sudden problems will come back. And that's where the key to solving this problem lies, because the problem is that the current therapeutic model reverses cause and effect, right? So the therapists assume that you're stressing your body because specific muscles that are supposed to be used for running are too weak or tight to work properly, and so you run wrong as a result. And that creates stress in your body, and then you get injured or you have pain. But in fact, before you started running at all, most or all of the muscles that you needed for running were weak. Maybe that was in childhood, maybe you've been running continuously through your life, or maybe you, like a lot of runners, started running at some point after age 20. And initially it was hard, but then gradually you got stronger and fitter for running. So the more fit, the better adapted you got to running, the stronger your running muscles, so to speak, got as a result of how you were moving. Running strengthens the muscles that you use for running. Sounds pretty straightforward, right? That's how it works. And so if some of the muscles that you need for running aren't strong, it's because the way you're running hasn't been using them. So in other words, the way that you run isn't a result of your strength. Your strength is a result of the way that you run. Movement comes before strength and produces strength, not the other way around.